So imagine a scenario where you have to prepare your meals. So you would perhaps open up your laptop, browse the internet for recipes, check their ingredients, check their Nutri-Score, and then send the recipe to a smart cooking device, as well as prepare an ingredient list or a shopping list and have it sent to your mobile phone. And all the three were achievable through Qt. So we had Qt running on the laptop, and that's Qt for WebAssembly. We had Qt on the smart device, that's Qt for embedded, and Qt for mobile. Qt for WebAssembly was something which we used very extensively for prototyping in the initial stage of the project. So imagine preparing an application and having to share it with your customer for feedback. Now with Qt for WebAssembly, all you need to do is make your application and just send them a URL or a link. It's as easy as that. No installations, no deployments. Our experience for Qt for MCU was refreshingly very interesting. We first developed the smart cooking device on a Linux-based hardware, which we were very comfortable with. So we then had to also develop it for the Qt for MCU. At first, it seemed a bit daunting to move an application into such a small bite-sized processor, but we managed to achieve it in a matter of 3 weeks, which is a lot about the technology that Qt's developed here. The development in our case was very accelerated because we used the Qt design studio, and through the design studio we managed to create the UI widgets that were easily portable across the three deployment scenarios. And there was also a very interesting Photoshop bridge in the design studio that must have saved us at least 4 weeks of effort.